Hello, I'm Ryan Wright.
And I'm Jerry.
So today we're going to check out the trailer for Now You See Me 2.
That's right, yeah. I like the first one.
Don't know why we're doing British accents.
I don't know either.
Everyone wanted a sequel to this many years later.
I had fun, man.
I had fun too.
I had a good time.
Predictable twist,
though. Yeah, it was predictable, but I still had a good time.
People were shocked by the twist.
People see the horsemen as noble Robin Hoods.
I forgot Dave Franco.
I believe their first act was just a setup for an even bigger reveal.
It's great to be back.
Where's Isla Fisher?
So nice to see you all again.
Where's Isla Fisher?
That Lizzie Kaplan?
Take another look.
Wow, magic's through the roof for this one.
So happy to be working with you.
Oh. No.
Ta-da!
Ah, yeah. Oh, you're a wizard, Harry. You're a fucking wizard.
I can already tell there's going to be a lot of people who are probably going to bitch about the fact that he's in it.
Ah, like, why?
Because it's like, oh, another Harry Potter movie. Like, you know how internet people can
be. Yeah, yeah. But if they are, then just shut up.
But I think that's fucking sweet. Daniel Radcliffe is a good actor. He's a really good actor. I think he's evolved a lot throughout the process of doing the Harry Potter films and post-Harry Potter. He's done some amazing work. I think that having him in this doing more of a comedic role, like from the 10 seconds we got, he's clearly not Harry Potter in this, you know?
He couldn't even catch that card.
Yeah, he's like, it looks like he's just having a fun time with this cast. What a great treat to have him in it, because Harry Potter, wizard magic and all that. It is a great treat to have Daniel Radcliffe in it.
He defeats Voldemort with a deck of cards, man. Yeah. He's back for more.
Yeah. I don't remember what the whole ordeal was with the first one where, I don't remember the details. A lot of the time you're questioning, is this real magic or is this tricks? Is this real magic or is this tricks? This looks like it's real magic the whole time. Yeah. Some of that shit I'm like, well, that's clearly CGI you're using, so... Yeah. This must be real magic instead of wait a minute, is that real or is that not real? I feel like they're just flat out saying, no, they're real magicians who do real magic. I like Lizzie Kaplan. She's a good actress. She's funny. She's really funny. But I did like Isla Fisher.
Yeah, I liked Isla Fisher a lot. I'm curious to know why she is not in this one. I like Lizzie Kaplan.
I can't tell if they replaced her or if it's just a new character. Either way, she's there to fit the role that, like, Isla Fisher couldn't come back for.
I think these days you can't
replace
actors like that.
It rarely works.
Yeah, like it kind of worked in The Dark Knight because people were already understanding of that. A lot of people were like, Katie Holmes. Whereas this movie, like, nobody has a reason to do that to Isla Fisher.
So
they brought in a completely different looking actress and went, ha, and then people would be like, what are you doing?
But I gotta say, Lizzie Kaplan, I think I liked Isla Fisher, but if I were to choose watching like something with Lizzie Kaplan and Isla Fisher, I'd probably go Lizzie Kaplan. I think she's more entertaining to watch. She's funny.
Well, you know, it's like I'd like to see Isla Fisher in more things so that we could get a better sense for her range. But it's like Lizzie Kaplan, we know that she can do comedy, drama, and everything in between.
Yeah.
You know, I love watching her generally, so I'm happy to see her in it.
Seeing Daniel Radcliffe in it got me super stoked.
Yeah.
That alone is like, I don't care about anything else I saw in that trailer. Seeing Daniel Radcliffe, because I'm always appealed to see something he's in. Even if he's not the greatest actor, I'm still interested to see what he's going to do. Seeing this, I'm like, oh, yeah, that's a perfect role for him.
Yeah.
It's perfect genre, because it's the magic world, but it's not like fucking the Harry Potter world at all. Totally different character. Good transition.
And it's a good way to build goodwill, you know, to have him, you know, he's breaking out of the Harry Potter mold finally, and so to kind of pop up in this movie about magic and be like, is fun, you know, it's a fun move.
Sometimes it makes sense, but sometimes I don't like it when actors get, like, famous off of one role, and then they try to just completely ignore anything to do with that role.
You know,
like, they're, as if they're ashamed of that role. So to see Daniel Radcliffe appear in this is kind of like, hey man, I'm cool with the whole Harry Potter thing, doing my own thing now, but I'm not ashamed to be in a film about magic again, like, come on.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's you know, he's clearly cool about it, you know, he's not taking himself overly seriously, he knows the reality, it seems like.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? It almost seems like the more you shun whatever thing puts you on the map or people associate you with, it just doesn't work out as well.
And I gotta say, the cinematography of this, like, the visual imagery of everything we got in this 1 minute, looks strikingly, like, solid and beautiful. I didn't get that visual sense when I saw the first one, but looking at this, I'm like, this looks like the DP of it is much more enhanced.
It looks fun and exciting, and it looks, you know, like it'll have a little bit of everything.
Yeah.
You know, I hope they just use this opportunity to improve a couple of the things that could have used improving from the first movie, and that's all you gotta do, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Make a fun, you know, high concept thriller and patch up the holes.
Well, anyway, guys, yeah, that film looks like a lot of fun. I'm probably gonna be there to watch it. I like any movie with an all-star cast. I like celebrities, and when I see a bunch of them come together, I'm like, I'm in, let's watch it.
Yeah, well, the first movie was fun, it had rhythm, you know, I probably enjoyed it more than Burt Wonderstone. So.
Oh, by far. Anyway, guys, if you're new to the channel, click this button right here, subscribe today, and become a reject. Yeah, and you can check out Reasons to Jerry and Dank Ass Stubs on this channel, playlist hosted by Jerry. Let's do a shout out. Christian J. Hayden. Hey Ryan, love your channel. Wait to see you on Conan.
I think it's want. Should be want.
Or can't wait.
Can't wait, yeah. I can wait. I can wait to see you on Conan.
Thanks, Christian J. Hayden. You're a nice lad. You're sexy. Let's see what you look like. All right, so before I was doing serial killer or not serial killer, now I'm looking at people's photos and going gay or straight.
Oh.
I figure that's more controversial. It'll upset more people, hence more comments. You know, I know what I'm doing. Everyone's seen the Dear Fat People video. I'm taking some inspiration.
Ugh.
Christian J. Hayden. All right, I got my thought. Gay or straight?
I'm not playing.
Play the game.
God damn it. Straight.
Straight?
He looks, I don't know.
I feel like he's straight.
How do you tell?
I feel like other guys might see this photo and be like, totally gay. But me, I'm like really examining him. Seems straight.
But what are you basing this on?
I can just feel it. I can feel it. Now let's look at his other photos. Whoa, dude. Your hair's covering your nipples. But you have huge nipples.
Not really.
Look at that one nipple on his right nipple. Look at that thing's like popping out. Look at that. That's a huge nipple.
It's not that big.
That's a perky nipple.
He's a relatively svelte guy.
You need to get nipple surgery.
No. Love your body.
Reduce your nipples.
Please don't.